Hello everyone. My name is Dai Chi, and I will give you the lecture regarding the radiation and remediation activities. So, let's start today's lecture. Today's theme is evacuation orders after the accident of the Fukushima Daiichi Nuclear Power Plant, Volume 2. Are you ready?
Mr. Daiichi, last time you talked about the designation of the evacuation areas and their reorganization. Are you going to talk about the rest of the story now?
Correct. After the reorganization of the evacuation areas, the evacuation orders were sequentially lifted, in the wake of the achievements, like the decrease of air dose rate. Let us see first the time transition.
Mr. Daiichi, before that, could you explain the specific difference between three evacuation areas, after the recategorization?
Okay, thank you for reminding me of that. I can't explain all of them, but you can see the points in this table. More detailed information can be obtained in the website of national government or other relevant organization. Specifically, the areas where the cumulative dose would not possibly be less than 20 millisievert per year in 5 years, and it was more than 50 millisievert per year at the time, were designated as the difficult to return zones. And the areas where cumulative dose from that point of time would possibly exceed 20 millisievert per year, and people were continuously required to evacuate, were designated as the habitation restricted areas. And areas among the existing evacuation areas where cumulative dose would surely be less than 20 millisievert per year were designated as the preparation areas for lift of evacuation. In every area, in principle, it was not allowed to stay overnight, but in the habitation restricted areas and the preparation areas for lift of evacuation, temporary return and through traffic were approved. And in the preparation areas for lift of evacuation, it was easier for businesses to be restarted, compared with other areas. Okay, from this slide onward, the evacuation orders in each municipality are sequentially lifted. First of all, the evacuation order in the part of the Tamura city was lifted in April 1, 2014.
By the way, under what kind of conditions the evacuation orders were lifted?
Right, at this moment, number 1, cumulative dose will become surely 20 millisievert per year or less. Number 2, most of infrastructures and life-relevant services are restored and decontamination made sufficient progress. With regard to the decontamination, in the difficult-to-return zones, it became possible to lift the evacuation order without decontamination, if it is agreed, between the relevant stakeholders. And last one is the sufficient discussion with the Fukushima Prefecture, relevant municipalities and residents. And in October 1, 2014, the habitation-restricted areas in the Kawachi village was categorized into the preparation areas of lift of evacuation order, and the evacuation order in the preparation areas for lift of evacuation order was lifted. After the designation of the specific spots for recommended for evacuation was lifted in the Minamisoma city in the end of 2014, the evacuation order in the Naraha town was lifted in September 2015. And in June 2016, the evacuation orders in the Katsureo village were lifted, both in the habitation restricted areas and the preparation areas for lift of evacuation. And in 2 days later, the evacuation order in the Kawachi village was lifted. And in the next month, the evacuation orders both in the habitation restricted areas and the preparation areas for lift of evacuation order were lifted in the Minamisoma city. And the end of March 2017, the evacuation orders both in the habitation restricted areas and the preparation areas for lift of evacuation order were lifted in the Iaitut village, the Kawamata town, and the Naimi town. And on the next day, the evacuation order in the habitation restricted areas and the preparation areas for lift of evacuation order in the Tomioka town were lifted. And 2 years later, in April 2019, the evacuation orders in the habitation restricted areas and the preparation areas for lift of evacuation order in the Akuma town were lifted. And on March 4, 2020, the evacuation order in the preparation areas for lift of evacuation order in the Futabat town was lifted. And by April 10th, in collaboration with the full reopen of JR Joban Railway, the evacuation orders for the stations and surrounding roads in the Akuma town, the Futabat town and the Tomiaka town in the difficult to return zones were lifted.
The evacuation areas were so much reduced, compared with the time shortly after the accident.
Correct. After 9 years passed, the evacuation orders were still declared only in the difficult to return zones.
Mr. Daichi, how has the life become in the areas where the evacuation orders were lifted? Has it become as it was? And what is going to happen to the difficult to return zones?
You provide me today a lot of good questions. Every point is very important. I would like to elaborate these points in other lectures. So, let me wrap up my lecture by providing you the key points. The evacuation orders declared shortly after the accident were sequentially recategorized into three new evacuation areas, based on the exposure dose. And there are three conditions for the lift of the evacuation orders. Specifically, first, the cumulative exposure dose needs to become for sure 20 millisievert or less. Second, infrastructure and life-related services need to be almost restored, and decontamination needs to be made enough progress. Third, the sufficient discussion with the Fukushima Prefecture, relevant municipalities and residents. Currently, all the evacuation orders were lifted, except for the difficult to return zones, in the wake of the decrease of air dose rate or other kinds of achievement. And even in the part of the difficult to return zones, the evacuation orders were lifted. The evacuation orders in the rest of the difficult to return zones need to be addressed. Okay, today's lecture is now dismissed. See you next time. In this channel, the useful information regarding the radiation and remediation will be provided to you. If you like it, please subscribe to this channel, and do not forget to click the like button.